Hi, I'm Jonathan, and we're in the De La Zerda Lab here in the Biophysics Department at Stanford. I grew up in a small town in Israel, right next to Tel Aviv. My mother is a psychiatrist. My father is an engineer. I have dyslexia. It's been a challenge because many people told me that there's some stuff that I would probably not be able to do. Sometimes people just say that you can't do something or things the way they are, and there's no real reason behind that. I wanted to do science from ever since that I remember myself. I don't know why, but I just love tough problems. You know, it's because of the challenge, because you fail so much, but once you get something right, I can't describe this feeling. Getting something right after you failed so long, that's what gets me. One of the things that scientists discovered is that cancer has this unique property of learning how to handle our medicine. And furthermore, they can actually tell their neighbor cells what they did in order to deal with that chemotherapy. Once we can actually hear them talk to one another, we can maybe intercept their communication and maybe trick them not to learn how to deal with the medicine that the person is getting. Or we can stop them from growing. We're actually building a device, or at least the first step of that device, that will enable us to actually hear those conversations. This is a model for cancer cells. And in here we're shining lasers on something that's called silicon beads. These are very, very small. They're actually very thin, thinner than your hair. And you can see them move a little bit with the laser beam. So here you can see the laser is pointing at this point, and there's another laser that's scanning on top. And you can see as this crosser comes over those beads, they're starting to move. And this is because we have some gold nanoparticles on top of them that are responsive to that. It's exciting to work with people that have a different background than you and have a different way of thinking and have a different history than what you've experienced. And I see that as a wonderful thing. I found myself a lot, knocking my head saying, Jesus, I should have talked about it. And how that person saw this.
So do you know what this is, by the way?
What is it?
Yeah. This is actually an electron microscope. So this is zooming down to those tiny, tiny, tiny secret agents I was telling you about before. They actually made some interesting shape there.
So it's a heart.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
You think?
So a few years ago, I started a program that's called Space IL, along with two friends, Kfir and Yariv. And our goal is to land the first Israeli unmanned spaceship on the moon. Okay, so this is a small-scale model of the spaceship. In real life, it's about the size of a washing machine. And this is the smallest spaceship ever designed for lunar landing. You cannot do like a beta and then test it and see if it works. You have to make it work for the first time. And we're going to get there to the moon, and that's very exciting. Stanford in general has many, many talented people around here, and these people tend to ask very good questions.
We got this really cool result the other day where we were looking at the cartilage, and I was wondering if you thought that I can think of any ways to try to bring in more vasculature.
Oh, I have no idea.
If you stay here long enough, you'll also start asking yourself this really amazing questions of why can't we do this and why is that not working, and I think that breaking down like this is the main reason science is so successful, because people thought, why can't we fly? And once the Wright brothers took on this challenge, they figured out, well, there's no real reason why we can't fly. We can actually fly, and today we all do that. What it turned to be is that aviation really started the what we call global world, and we never could have seen the world today without aviation, and there was no way to see back then how the world would look like after aviation has been invented. And I think that our field right now is in the same spot. Success is not a linear graph that you start from here and you get there. It's a very tricky road, and in the end, I think it's worth it. And this is why I'm here. Don't think about whether or not you can do this. It's irrelevant. What's relevant is that you want to do this, and you're going to enjoy every day in your life doing this. So why not try it? I mean, life is too short to not follow your dreams.